A general's daughter has written a book on the love story that was the life of her parents. Ashali Varma is the daughter of Lieutenant General Prem Singh Bhagat, co-author of the secret Henderson Brooks-Bhagat inquiry into the defeat in the China War, and the first Indian to win the Victoria Cross in the Second World War.
He never ever spoke about it. I mean never. And when I say never, I mean it. Maybe he spoke about it to my mother. But to the children, to friends who said, please describe the action to us, he would say, oh, I was just doing my duty. It's not really worth it. So he was, in that way, he was very modest. But at the same time, I think there were things that he didn't want to go into regarding, you know, his driver being killed when he was blown up. Those things hurt him a lot, that his men suffered. Okay, and he considered it completely as doing his duty.
It took a trip to London to meet the Queen for Ashali to realize the significance of the honor.
That entire honor being put on all the Victoria Crosses and people interviewing them and the Queen meeting up with each of them in Buckingham Palace, then naturally you think, my God, this is something bigger than I thought. It's not just any medal, you know, it is something bigger, but it took me that long to realize because he never would speak about it.
Bhagat and Lieutenant General Henderson Brooks were tasked to study the reasons for India's loss in the war against China. That report is still classified today in spite of RTI applications for its release. Ashali thinks the truth should come out.
I think it should be released. I don't have the exact facts of the report because he was not allowed to keep a single copy. It was all very hush-hush. But from whatever I've read, and I've read a lot, like the Maxwell book, and from the little I heard from my father before he died, from what my mother told me, I think the report should be released because I think China already has the report.
Bhagat's daughter thinks the real reason the report remains secret is to protect the reputations of the political leadership during the war.
It's more to protect the political fallout that happened at that time. It's more about protecting that because from what I heard, my father pulled out all stops. He just talked about what Krishna Menon had, you know, how much he had bungled. He talked about how some of the commanders in the field had bungled, how the people who could have made a difference weren't allowed to make a difference. So, I mean, that really points out to a really big problem at the top.
As auditors of India's performance in the war, they faced a lot of institutional resistance.
So when he actually went to meet people in the government or who were involved in any way with the China debacle, I mean, he was stymied at every level. So he had to actually go to the soldiers, he had to actually dig for information. And he managed to do a pretty good job according to what people say. That is why the report is still not released.
Bhagat had warned of the Chinese threat before the war. While the inquiry is still secret today, the earlier paper was ignored.
He had written a 31-page paper on all the things that India would need actually defeat China, and we were capable of it. It wasn't that we didn't have the training, it was just that the soldiers were so badly treated by the politicians. I mean, it was a political gamut that was being played.
Widely expected to become the army chief, Bhagat was forced into retirement, becoming ineligible after the incumbent General Bevoor was given an extension. Ashali remembers the disappointment and thinks it was because he wasn't a pliable officer.
He was very disappointed because he had everything going for him. He was the senior most, the most decorated, his men loved him, he had done a brilliant job wherever he was in the army. So for him, no reason for him, for the government not to make him chief. So initially he was very disappointed and he did ask Mrs. Gandhi, which I write in the book, that, have I disappointed you in some way? And she said, no. I mean, we have other plans for you. But I believe it was the bureaucracy, along with Jagjivan Ram, who said that he would not be a malleable general. And he would not have been a malleable chief. He would not have listened. I mean, just a year after all this, emergency was declared. Had he been in the army, I don't think he would have accepted it.
And what would he have thought of the situation the army faced in the past couple of years, with battles for succession and promotions?
Well, from what he himself did, I mean, he didn't fight it. He was the natural person to become chief, and he didn't go and sue the government or anything. And he had the backing of the whole army. Yet, he just quietly retired, because he thought that the army is the most disciplined force in the country. It should not meddle in politics. At the same time, he did expect the politicians to have the right kind of feeling for the army also, you know, so that it didn't consider it just an organization that was there for its own use, when and where to use, which is what it did in China for the Chinese debacle. So there is a fine balance, he thought, but he would have not approved of what was going on, what is going on today, like, you know, people going to the government, army people going to the government to sue for an extension or for age limits or things like that. I don't think he would have done that, because he didn't do it for himself, so I think he would have disapproved of it.
Ashali doesn't think her father would have considered something like a military coup likely in India.
You know, from my father's point of view, it was not conceivable in India. And there is a passage where I talk about when Nehru sort of jokingly asked my father, "So, Colonel, when are General Tamaya and you going to take over the country?" At that point, they were politically very vulnerable and scared, because Pakistan had just been taken over by the army. And General Tamaya was a very popular chief. So my father was shocked, and he said, he never used to tell me things, but when I grew up, he told me this one thing, that in India, the army should never ever take over, ever. Because it's the only institution that has, I mean, in that is keeping this country safe. And the moment it comes in as a coup and the people get the power to do whatever they want, then India will not be what it should be.
After leaving the army, Bhagat was tasked by K.C. Pant, who died last week, to turn the Damodar Valley Corporation around.
He got it right in the beginning, and that, I think, was his quality of man management. K.C. Pant also was one of the people who actually had the political will. And he told me, my father, that if it had not been for K.C. Pant, he would not have been able to do half the things he did. So, first of all, political will is important. Secondly, he did have a big problem, because DVC, the morale was low, the unions were acting up, and they had never ever worked. You know, the people were not used to a work ethic because of low morale. And he said, we had some of the best engineers. It was not that we didn't have the talent. It was just that they were so ignored that they just didn't want to work. I mean, there were engineers who hadn't been given a promotion for 12 years. He made it a point to go and meet 7,000 people. All 7,000 employees. He got into their problems and he says, I'll fix your problems, you work with me. And that is how he managed to change the whole aspect of the company.
The military hero's daughter is still upset about the manner of his passing. His life was cut short at the age of 56, just 10 months into his tenure as chairman of the Damodar Valley Corporation. According to the book, it was due to medical malpractice.
It was hushed up. The media and everybody else was told that he had died of a heart attack or of pneumonia. But actually, he was given penicillin, and the doctor gave him penicillin, the army doctor Subramaniam, knowing fully well that he was highly allergic to penicillin. That is something unforgivable, I think. And it sort of haunts you. You feel guilty that you weren't there enough to grab the penicillin out of the nurse's hand, you know, because it's such a stupid way to go. I mean, you know, he had been blown up 3-4 times. He had had a car accident where they thought that he had died. And then to be lying in bed, having just with a bad throat and fever, and to be given the wrong medication is gross malpractice. I mean, what else can it be?
Besides the general readership, she hopes this book will also introduce the man to later generations of her family. Her son, for instance, never got to know him personally, having only heard about him from his grandmother Mohini.
My mother told him a lot about my father. My mother never stopped talking about my father after he died. So through my mother, he got to know my father quite a bit, but not through the letters that I brought out in the book. He didn't know him as a whole person. It's so difficult if person is no more to recreate a whole person in somebody's mind. But I think this book will help that in a way, because it puts together all the stories my mother told and his military history and what he was to his men.
Mohini decided to travel the world after Bhagat passed away, still being recognized as the wife of the VC.
She was cashing a check, and that German cashier couldn't understand her how to pronounce Bhagat. So she said, "Would you spell it out, ma'am?" And when she spelled it out, this gentleman behind said, "I couldn't help hearing you, ma'am, but are you in any way related to the late Lieutenant General P.S. Bhagat?" And she was stunned, and she said, "Yes, I'm his wife." And he happened to be somebody who had known and loved my father.
Ashali thinks her mother was just as courageous as General Bhagat.
I thought a book about my father would not be complete without my mother in it. And the time that I was closest to my mother was the 5 months when I was looking after her. So I needed to put that in to show the different kinds of courage. My father's courage as a Victoria Cross, what it took to demine those fields, and my mother's courage that she went through the most painful cancer with the greatest of grace.
The Victoria Cross, A Love Story, is available on Flipkart.